Pearl is secretly an insane brawler and everybody is sleeping on her. I'm going to show you why Pearl is secretly an amazing brawler and how you can properly play her to see why she's an amazing brawler. To start off, Pearl has one of the lowest trophy rates on the leaderboards, capping at around 1,500 and about only a max of 2,000 in the whole world. This number, compared to almost every other brawler, is significantly lower because most people dedicate an account to pushing someone to about 7, 8, 9, or 10,000. But for Pearl, that is just not the case because Pearl is overlooked. Really, I don't hear anything about her ever. She always comes in at around C tier on tier list, but today I'm going to show you why she should be B, A, or maybe even S tier. Pearl was insane on release and people thought so, and then she steadily got to get less and less traction. Then after her hypercharge came out, which is one of the worst in the game, she was just written off as not a good brawler. I can see why. Her hypercharge is really, really bad unless you know how to play it in certain game modes. But Pearl's hyper, I only use it for the stat buffs and not exactly for the duration. One thing about Pearl is she is super high skill, and while you might think her wide attack, there are other factors that definitely play into why she is super high skill. Let's get right into why she is an amazing brawler. Pearl has a unique trait that whenever her bar charges up without shooting, she does more and more damage with her shots. This is one reason she is super, super high skill, because you have to preserve your ammo and not just waste it so you can get the max amount of damage out of your shots. Her super also depletes her bar completely unless you have the star power that only depletes half of it. Now that one just isn't as good in many game modes because having a shield is overall way better. As you can see, me and that Pearl who just died were both using it because it is the overall better star power. Pearl being a damage dealer is also very, very good to play aggressive with, but you have to know when to play aggressive. Here, I do have my bar fully charged up, and this surge over here has less power cubes than me, so I am gonna wait for him to rush like this, and then I'm gonna use my burn. And I thought he would die here, but he doesn't. He will die later on. Overall, I can just be super aggressive, and another thing you have to remember about her is that you have to keep range because you have it. Other than Janet, Pearl has the longest cone attack, which is a wider attack than most longer range brawlers, which is amazing for hitting most of your shots, and overall does decrease her skill just a little bit. She's still one of the more higher skill brawlers in the game. Now before I can talk more about her, I need to get into her build real quick. For her gadget, you want to run Overcooked because it overall just does more damage to the enemy. It prevents them from healing and marks them in bushes and can do much more, and has definitely helped me clutch a 1v1 scenario multiple times. For the star power, we already talked about this, run Heat Shield, so that way whenever your bar is over 80%, you take 20% reduced damage, which if you're playing Showdown, Knockout, or Bounty, this can definitely help you stay alive longer and get more kills, which is your goal in all three of these game modes. You want to run the damage gear and either the health or the bush speed gear depending on how many bushes are on the map. I would say if there's about 30% bushes on the map, so a little bit more than this one, then you definitely want to run the speed because she is overall a slower brawler and dodging is a key part in playing Pearl. For open maps, you definitely want to be healing out in the open, so healing as fast as possible is perfect. Now, I know I already touched on this, for your game modes you want to be playing either solo, showdown, knockout, or bounty because she's a super good damage dealer and can pick off a kill really easy. Personally play showdown just because I think it's pretty easy right now and the knockout map's horrible for Pearl right now, and bounty is not in rotation. Okay, now I'm just gonna go over my gameplay here and show you most of the highlights and how I got my kills here. So here, I kept my range on this Cordelius, and then I knew that he was probably gonna come into this bush, so I got ready to super. The key part in playing Pearl is that you have to keep range, especially if you're in showdown. You definitely need to be charging up your super early in the match, so that way you can defend against any close range brawlers. So here I did try to keep my super because I knew that Edgar was just gonna jump. I still ended up dying because Edgars are gay. Big thing I keep in mind in this match is ammo tracking, where you want to make sure you're looking at other people's ammo, especially if they have a low reload speed. And when you're attacking boxes, you can use all three of your shots to defeat one, or you can wait for your bar to charge up to only use two shots. I use three on both of these because no one's really near me and the surge didn't decide to rush me. But here, since my bar is about one third to half of the way full, I know I can only use two and I'll be fine just using two. And I, since that Jackie just ran out of that bush, I'm probably gonna go down to it, and I just use one or two shots to try to chip at my super because the super will become massively important later in the match and you always need to make sure you have it. You always want to keep one or two ammo because her reload speed is at a medium pace, so just in case someone jumps on you like an Edgar or a Kit or a Lily, you want to make sure you have enough ammo to defend yourself. Now since I have my shield here for the rest of the match, I'm going to try to not let the shield go away, so I'm only going to shoot once or twice at a time. Here I'm just waiting for someone to get into my range so I can chip my super a little bit because I do have a longer range than both of these people, and I see the Jackie come down here. So I try to chip my super off her, but it is unsuccessful. Make sure you stick around for next match because the match after this this is absolutely insane. Here you need to watch this play. So I fake my super here so he jumps away, and it just forces him back into that corner with no super now, so I can just come in and super him right here. I probably didn't need to super, but I did anyway. I kind of just lay low and don't shoot to get my bar to recharge, hoping that Buzz won't press me. He's using the other gadget, so he can't really latch onto me. But I am probably charging his super here, so I just kind of force him out of this bush, knowing I almost have my super again. And now I have this bush to myself, so I can kind of just relax in it. So yeah, I'm just kind of chipping my super here, waiting for something to happen. Just overall getting a better defense for myself. Nothing really happens here except a super in a second. And then this Jackie is trying to team with me right now, and you best know that I do not team. So I go and put an X right on that heart because no teaming is allowed in this game. Now, I don't think at the time I realized that there might be someone down there because I never actually ended up shooting and checking that bush. And I couldn't exactly tell if the Jackie sprayed that or someone else did. And it was a Lily, so. I got unlucky there, I could have gotten killed. And I know she's probably gonna come into this bush, so I get ready to super and boom. You know, I have to pick off that kill. I don't actually get it. I get super scared here, kill the Lily, so now I have an instant fourth, and I die to the Jackie super. This next match, I start off as normal. I have my super chipped off of the bull, and there's 8 people left, and I have a bush in the middle, which is huge, especially since there's only 4 bushes. So there's only gonna end up being 4 people left in the end, which is basically a guaranteed fourth place for me. Me and this bull kind of edge each other a little bit, and we just keep going back, you know, faking our supers a little bit. It's kind of dumb. Nothing really happens there, so I kind of just fast forward it for you. This bull made a stupid move of popping his T-bone right there and got nothing off of it, so he's probably going to rush me soon, and I am just ready to super the heck out of him. And then I see the surge, and I just go super him instead, because it's a smarter move. I try to push away the Lily from me, hoping she'll get into the bull, but then she just shadow realms like all Lilies do. And here I wasn't really expecting anything. The bull and the Lily were just gonna heal up. So I'm kind of just chipping my super here, expecting the Lily to be up top, but she wasn't. And then I get supered here, but it was the worst super I've ever seen. If you go into replay, we can see froze in horror of how horrible his super was. We'll probably do the same. That was the worst thing I've ever seen. Also using the wrong gadget. The other one's so much better. I'm hoping the Lily presses him here. I'm kind of just waiting for him to come up if he does. I'm watching for the Lily too because I know she might super. I get him low, so maybe the Lily will super him instead. She does, going hyper super, and then I absolutely pre-fry the crap out of that Lily and win. So yeah, that is why Pearl is one of the most underrated brawlers in the game. And I suggest maxing her out right now because I don't see any buffs or nerfs in the future, so she would be a very, very consistent brawler. I'll catch you guys in the next video. I hope you like this one. If you have any video ideas, drop them in the comments. Disagree with me, please say so in the comments too. Like and subscribe.